CFDA, the Council of Fashion Designers of America, depends on corporate partners to put forth objectives, and one of the objectives of the fashion industry of late has been how do you become more sustainable and what's the place for eco fashion in the overall fashion arena. And I think for us to have Lexus Hybrid Living as our partner lends a tremendous amount of credibility given the work that Lexus has already done in this area, and really provides some guidance as we connect those opportunities to designers, American designers.
Well, the whole idea actually came about because what we want to do is promote sustainability and manufacturing practices, much in the same way that Lexus is the environmental leader. I mean, we coined the phrase luxury hybrid. And so this partnership actually gives us a platform to celebrate designers that are doing that same thing, that have a dedication and a focus and a commitment towards providing sustainable products, but without sacrificing any style or luxury.
Well, this is a great event. It's a convergence of an amazing, very progressive luxury car company with a design community, you know, the American Fashion Design Council, which is really the, I believe, the leaders of where we're taking, you know, the language of sustainability going forward. So it's a really great convergence.
Our line in general is sort of, it's just, you know, for us it's always just about the woman. It's always about, it always starts with the female form. And I think, you know, one thing that we've been excited about was kind of introducing this kind of, you know, the idea of kind of sustainable and green to our brand.
I think you couldn't have two better partners come together. The CFDA represents some of the most exclusive and sophisticated and forward-thinking designers in America, and Lexus is just as forward-thinking, you know, with their green technology and also combining luxury with green technology. So it's a wonderful evening.
I actually started doing organic pieces in my collection in 2008, so I've been doing it for a while, and it's something that has been done, you know, for me in a very artisanal way, and I just really wanted to sort of explore, you know, what you could bring into fashion that was very specifically organic in terms of working with natural fibers, and the fabrications, you know, that were organic in nature were really my starting point and my inspiration.
So I think it's great that Lexus put together this initiative to really spotlight designers who are conscientious of the world that we live in. The main thing in the jewelry is that it's all sourced from vintage materials. So it's about reclaiming and reappropriating old manufactured parts and things that have been cast off and you know, kind of laid to waste, and recreating those into new contemporary designs.
I think it's an amazing way to bring people together and actually make them aware of you know, what we're up against, you know, to actually be eco-friendly. It's not an easy thing in this day and age. So I think even just the awareness that it creates is amazing.
I think that it's wonderful, and I think that it's going to be a wonderful alignment in terms of education. It's going to work for both the consumer. It's also going to be great for students, design students.
I think it's a great event to be part of, and I'm really happy that there's a more concentrated effort across the board for fashion, and especially to have Lexus behind it and all their efforts in contributing to the environment.
My inspiration for the Eco Challenge was just, I mean, I have been incorporating eco-friendly pieces into my collection for quite a while, so it was really just making sure I had really enough to make the 25%, which I do, and it was actually really good to do that interview, or, well, I did mine as an interview, but to do that application, because it kind of like tests you and makes you think about how you're working.
Thank you to Lexus, thank you for the CFDA for having us here, thank you to all the 10 designers who are participating in the event. So we're going to get to the three top choices here. The first name here, Monique Pian. Congratulations, Monique. Come on up.
I'd just like to say thank you so much to everybody here who's out to support me and to the CFDA and to Lexus and to Scott, who actually has paved the way as one of our first major eco-friendly designers. So this is fabulous. Thank you so much. And I hope that every other designer thinks about other ways to be eco-friendly and sustainable. Thank you.
Costello Tagliapietra. Congratulations.
Just want to say thank you to everybody. And again, thank you to the CFDA and to Lexus. And we're super excited.
Via Cornejo.
To be honest, it's really humbling because I was in such great company. And just to be in the last 10 was amazing. So thank you, guys. Really humbling. I'm really, like, touched.